is Markus Rottmaier, Head of Sales Business Development at Microsoft's Commerce Division and Social Media Platform Ciao. First of all, before we go and start, I'd like to excuse our both general managers who basically couldn't make it today because of last week's procurement incidents, which basically messed up the entire schedule, so we kind of jumped in right there. In today's presentation, I'm going to walk through with you where the internet impacts on consumer behavior, the growing of importance of search and communities, managing your brand through consumer's voice, and of course the new era of recommendations.
Blending our work and our home lives as we take our mobile around and we're checking email when we're out of the office. You know, it's a very, very different lifestyle that we're living, and those worlds are blending. Also, access to internet at the workplace. Years ago, no one was able to get internet. It was a real privilege to get internet at the workplace. Now, most of us just take that for granted. You know, you can go online, maybe check something whilst you're at work. So it's very, very different. The other trend that we're certainly seeing is this whole celebrity, reality star, image culture. It's quite amazing. You know, me, I'm a search engine product manager. One thing that just blew me away the other day was the day of the volcano. Okay, the volcano, everyone's talking about it on the news. So what would you think the most popular terms are in the search engine? Volcano? Volcano ash? No, it was Amanda Flowers, We Fit. This woman got this strange sex addiction to We Fit. So it's just quite remarkable to see that we're a celebrity. Someone suddenly sees, you know, the tabloid and the headlines and thinks, oh, actually, I'd quite like to know more about that. And, oh, if the We Fit can do that for her, then what about me? You know, so it's one of those things. Also, you know, quite incredible for us to see is things like, you know, Stephen Fry. I love Stephen Fry. Now, how many of you are fans? He's got 1.5 million followers on Twitter. You know, he suddenly has a bad experience with the product. Not mine, by the way, not yet. And he tweets about it, and everybody knows, and everybody's, you know, you've suddenly got that mass of people, you know, tweeting, blogging about it, and then it lands in the press. So it's quite interesting to see this connected society where you've got people who are online, they're accessible on their mobile, they're accessible, they've got direct 24-hour access to email, and then suddenly, you know, as the day goes by, they get influenced by either things, you know, real-life experiences or other people. It's quite remarkable to see how suddenly their behaviour starts setting in motion. They start searching for things, they start adding reviews, they start expressing their opinion, retweeting. And then again, you see all of that bubbling up when you're searching for your brand. You're seeing, my goodness, you know, all of a sudden there's all these links on my brand that I don't control, their opinion sites, and maybe they're saying good things, maybe they're saying bad things about me. But, you know, it's about sort of being aware of all those connections. So the other thing is, with all of this 24-hour connected society, there's too much information. We're in this information search overload. And one of the things that certainly all of the search engines have said is we need to make it easier for people to actually get to the information, to find products, services, brands that matter. For example, I type in mobile phones, okay, type it into a search engine, and I get 169 listings on mobile phones. I'm not going to read through 169 million listings. It's just impossible. So what we're trying to do is look at what's the type of information that is important in terms of making a decision. How can we make it relevant in that first page? Because we know, at the moment, only 1 in 4 times do people actually get to the result, to the information to help them make a decision within that first page. You're going to have to flip back, flip forward, you're going to have to click on other links, you're going to have to refine your query. It's all a bit tedious. So what we're trying to do is bring all of that, all of those features, all of that information within the first page of the listings to help you make decisions easier using the search engines that are available today.